Today, we passed a series of common sense reforms to the so-called New York SAFE Act. This was a controversial law that was passed in the dead of night a couple years ago before I was a New York State Senator. It absolutely was an infringement on our Second Amendment rights, on our constitutional rights, and is a major issue for my constituents, and I believe for all New Yorkers. I campaigned against the SAFE Act. It was a major part of my campaign and my pledge to my constituents that we would address this. And I one of the first acts I did as a New York State Senator was to be a co-sponsor of a bill to repeal the SAFE Act. I have been unwavering in my commitment to our Second Amendment rights and to getting rid of this law. And I'm encouraged today, and I commend our new Majority Leader, Senator John Flanagan, who, when he took over as leader, pledged that he would do something about the SAFE Act, very important to our upstate members particularly, and I commend him and all my colleagues for voting on these very common sense reforms to the SAFE Act, and I believe a step in the right direction. If somebody is referred for mental health reasons to a database or to law enforcement, they are notified of that referral, and their due process and their rights are protected. Family members can give or gift a rifle to another family member in their will or as part of their estate, which happens very commonly up in my district. We return local control to our county clerks as far as pistol registration, and we protect people's private their rights to privacy by not putting out information on pistol licenses, and we statutorily and hopefully finally eliminate the ammunition database, which we've done in the budget, but now we've done it statutorily through legislation. So common sense reforms, and I think these reforms highlight some of the problems with the New York SAFE Act as it was passed, and these changes are long overdue, and I think are a good first step in the right direction. And so I was very proud to cast a yes vote in the affirmative for these changes today.